أفلح من صلى على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد
وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أثاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
قال الله العلي العظيم في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب الجنة إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون. فطاف عليها طائف من ربك وهم نائمون. فأصبحت كالصريم فتنادوا مصبحين أن اغدوا على حرثكم إن كنتم صارمين. وغدوا على قادرين فانطلقوا وهم يتخافتون ألا يدخلنها عليكم اليوم مسكين ألا يدخلنها اليوم عليكم مسكين. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
One of the beauty of the Quran is that sometimes when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to get some point across to us, Allah wants to teach us something. He wants to draw our attention to something. He wants to educate us. One of the things He does is to share a story with us. Story about something that happened somewhere at certain point, at certain time, so we can learn the lesson. But the point is that we all read or hear stories. But people are divided into two when it comes to story. Sometimes when we hear a story, we're so amazed about it. We laugh. We think it's funny. And it stays in our mind. Sometimes some people know when we hear story or read story, we cry because it's a sad story, sad ending. That is what happens with us sometimes. But the Quran comes to tell you that when Allah tells you a story, Allah said, I don't want you to cry. The message is not for you to cry. When Allah tells you a story in the Quran, Allah said, I don't want you to laugh. That's not a message. Because stories are in the Quran in so many places. Even there is a surah, Allah called it Suratul Qasas. The chapter of stories. Many stories about people, Allah mentioned in that story. So Allah tells you in the Quran, when we tell you a story, you know what we want you to do? Allah said, we want you to take a lesson, a message. إِنَّ لَفِي قَصَصِهِمْ لَعِبْرَةٌ. The stories that we tell in the Quran, Allah said, those stories are to be a lesson for you and I. And what are the message? That when you read the story, if the story is about bad people, learn not to be like them. If the story is something good, like Ashab al-Kahf, you learn to be like them. That is the message. Tonight, I want to share with you a story of Quran. It's called Qisas al-Quran. Story from Surah Al-Qalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shares the story for all of us. And then at the end of the story, I want you and I to take some messages from this story. This story, it happened. It's a real story. It's not a fiction story. It's a real story Allah is telling you and I. And this story, they say, it happened in Yemen, in a city called Sana'a. It's a real story, took place in Yemen. But some of us didn't say no. It wasn't in Yemen, it was in Habasha, in Ethiopia. Some of us didn't say no, it was not in Ethiopia. It happened in Sham. But the majority of our Mufassirin, they say, no, the story took place in Yemen. What is the story? The summary of the story is this. They say an old man used to live in Yemen with his family. He has five children, and he had a big farm. Very huge farm. That every year, when the time of harvest comes, when the end of the year comes, what the man does, he divides his farm into three. One third of everything in the farm, one third, he invites poor people to come and he share with them. Every year. He even told the neighbors, the poor people in the neighborhood, he said, when you see my farm has come to the end of the year, when it's about to harvest, he said, don't wait for me to ask you. Come in. It's your share and come and get your part, your share. So the poor people in the neighborhood, they're always watching the farm. When the farm is about to ripe, he come in and he give them their share. That is the farmer. Then the second two-third, what he does, he sells them. He sells to make money so he can live off of. He can share with his family. He can buy things he needs. The third part, he keeps for his family. Three things he does. One part, one third for the poor, two third for seven, the third as for his family. And he has been doing this for years. Suddenly the father died. The night the father died, you know the children, what did they say? The five children that he had, they said, Alhamdulillah. Well, they didn't say Alhamdulillah in that word. But the action, okay, now dad is gone. But dad is not a smart guy. Why the dad is not a smart guy? Because he's giving the farm to the other people. He shouldn't be doing that. And here, between the parentheses, before I continue, you know, brothers, most of the time, we think not doing good is a smartness, it's a sign of smartness. And that is why they say, the Prophet, hadith from the Prophet, he said, "Inna akthara ahli al-jannati al-bulla." Allahu Akbar. The majority of people of heaven, they are the people we call retarded people. When you enter heaven, majority of the people who will be enjoying in the heaven are the people we call them retarded. They are not smart. Because they're doing things which is the right thing. But we think, no, it's not the right thing. It should be done the other way around. The Prophet said the most of the people in the heaven, they are the ones who we consider them retarded. Now you reverse it. The people of hellfire are whom?
Smart.
Who call themselves? Smart guys. Right? They understood, they know things. So they don't do like those guys. So the Prophet said the majority of them who think they're smart, they are the ones who end up in the hellfire. That is this young man. When their father died, they said that now the father doesn't understand. He shouldn't be giving the farm to the poor people. So what did they say? Now listen to the Quran. From here the ayah start, "Inna balawnahum kama balawna ashab al-jannah." Al-jannah here, a garden, the farm of the father. Allah said, we tested them. How did Allah test them? Allah took the father died. Now what did they say? "Idha aqsamu," they swear by Allah. They say, we swear by Allah. Allah yasrimunnaha musbihin. That from tomorrow, Except the farm is now in our control. We are now in charge. Now what should we do? أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ. You see, any poor person in the city would not be allowed to come to the town, to the farm. From today, no poor person will taste the farm because the father who used to give you is gone. Now we are in control and we are not sharing the farm with anybody else. Now what happened?
They sat down. They have a small conference.
What is the conference about? They all decided, five of them, that tomorrow morning we will go to the farm early in the morning before anybody wakes up.
We will be there at the farm.
What do? We block all the entrance of the farm
and then making sure that nobody comes in.
Agreed?
Agreed. Allahu Akbar. They were one of them.
One of them among the five.
He said, no, don't do that. Fear Allah. This farm belongs to Allah.
Yes, his father, our father is the owner of the land. He is the one who plants it. But the giver of all this blessing is Allah.
They said, no, you don't get it either.
What happened? They finally convinced him to come with them.
So they all decided, tomorrow morning, we're going to the farm.
Early in the morning.
And early in the morning, they woke one another up. Come on, you remember the agreement? We're going to the farm? Yes, come on. And Quran says,
they woke up in the morning, وَهُمْ يَتَخَافَتُونَ.
They were speaking to one another,
التَخَافَتْ. They whispering, they don't want anybody to hear what the plan is about, what is the secret about, because they don't want the poor guys, the needies, to hear what the plan is, so they can come and meet them at the farm.
They woke up in the morning, they were heading to the farm. Allahu Akbar.
They got to the farm,
they couldn't find, they couldn't locate the farm.
قالوا إنا لضالون.
What happened to the farm? Can't find it. Allahu Akbar. This is the farm they used to go since they were young.
They always were there with their father. They always started the farm with the father. They know everything about the farm.
Now what happened today? They can't locate the farm? One of them said, بل نحن محرومون. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want us to have this farm anymore.
The other one said, the one who was advising them not to do that, Quran said, قال أوسطهم ألم أقل لكم لولا تسبحون.
Tell them to remind them, say, listen, you know I told you, don't do this.
Don't prevent the poor people from the farm. Let them have their share as our father used to do. Quran said,
فَأَقْبَلُوا.
They started
يَتَلَاوَمُونَ. They started accusing one another. You are the bad guy. It was your idea. So you had this one more idea, but you accepted it too. They started accusing one another.
Now what happened? Now Quran tells you and I that what happened is to the farm, Quran say as they make that intention to stop the poor people from entering the farm,
and they want to sleep, right?
At night,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِنْ رَبِّكْ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ. Allahu Akbar. While they made the niyyah, they will prevent all the poor people from the farm.
They went to sleep. As they were asleep, Allah said, فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِنْ رَبِّكْ.
Allah said, we sent a storm.
At that night,
the farm was ready. Time to
benefit from the farm. But because of what they said, because of what they are planning to do, at the night, the same night when they went to sleep,
Allah said, فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكْ وَهُمْ نَاحِمُونَ. Allah said, we sent a storm.
What storm was it?
A fire storm.
Fire storm? And the fire came, what did he do? Allah said it in the next ayah, he said,
فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ.
As-sareem in Arabic,
it turns to like a charcoal.
Dark. everything was burnt. The farm that was ready for people to harvest, and look at the miracle. There were many farms next to it, left and right, front and back, but the rest of the farms were fine. The only farm that was affected was the farm of the father who died. They can't enter it. They couldn't recognize the farm. Allahu Akbar. It's not the farm that our father left yesterday. It was well organized, arranged. It's all green. But now it turns to what? To black, burnt from head to toe. What happened? Quran said to them, كَذَلِكَ الْعَذَابَ وَالْعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Here, the Quran mentioned that when they saw this, they started to return back to their sins. They started saying to each other, إِنَّا لَظَالِمُونَ. We did injustice to ourselves. Then they said, إِنَّا إِلَى رَبِّنَا رَاغِبُونَ. We're now asking Allah to give us the best of what He has from Him, not this what our father left. But Allah said, كَذَلِكَ الْعَذَابُ وَالْعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Here some mufassirin, they said, they did the tawbah to Allah. When they saw the farm was burned, they did tawbah. But Allah didn't accept their tawbah. Why? Because not all the tawbah Allah accept. Because tawbah, it has to meet certain conditions. If a tawbah does not meet condition, it's in the trash. It has to meet certain conditions. Allah said in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةُ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ حَتَّى إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ. There are conditions of tawbah. But some of us sitting there say no. What happened later on? They did realize their mistake and they did the true repentance and Allah accepted them. But the point is this. They lost their farm, they lost their dad, and they committed sin. Now here's the lessons, brothers and sisters. That's the summary of the story. But now the lesson, the take home message for all of us. Number one. We have to understand in Islam, giving and sharing is one of the pillars of Islam. In Islam, whatever Allah gave you, it doesn't matter. Islam said, try to share with others. Now, share with you some ayahs in the Quran. You know, when you go in the Quran, we have different titles. The title number one is called title of mu'min. One of the quality of mu'min is they have to be given. It's Surah Al-Mu'minun. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. One of the quality of mu'minun, they give zakat. Whatever Allah gives them, they share with the others, the needy. That's number one. Now go to another higher level than the mu'min, which is muttaqi. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Whatever we gave them, they share with the others. Sharing is one of the pillars of Islam. Now you come to Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. One of the quality of Ahlul Bayt is giving and sharing with whatever Allah has given them. One example from Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. There are many of them from the Quran. Example number one. Ayat Surah Al-Dahr. Imam Ali alayhi salam, he and his family. وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, Quran was quoting them. 3 days they were given their food. The first day they were fasting. A poor person came, they knocked the door, they gave all their food away. The second day a person came and he was an orphan, they gave the food away. The third day another person came who was a prisoner, they gave it away. After the third day Allah was amazed Allah was so happy to see this type of giving from Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Allah sent the ayah, وَيُطْئِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَصِيرًا. And you know what is beautiful? What is amazing about the ayah? Allah said, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. When we feed, the intention should be just for the sake of Allah, not show off, not to please yourself, not to please anybody. It's supposed to be just for Allah. That is number one. A giving from Ahlul Bayt, Imam Ali alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Imam Ali alayhi salam, when he was in the masjid, and it's mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Imam Ali was in the masjid, a poor person enters the masjid, he says, I ask everyone in the masjid. Nobody paid attention to him. Nobody gave him anything. He was leaving the masjid. Imam Ali was there. The man rose his hand. He says, Allahumma shahad anni dakhaltu masjid Rasulillah. Ya Allah, I want you to bear witness. I entered the mosque of your prophet. Fasa'alt. And I ask everyone in the masjid. فَمَا أَعْطَانِي مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. Nobody gave me anything. As he was leaving the masjid, Imam Ali was praying next to the door. Imam Ali alayhi salam stretched his hand towards the man, indicating, take my ring. Allahu Akbar. The man realized this. He took the ring of Imam Ali. And this incident happened just between the two of them. And the third one was Allah. After Imam Ali left the masjid, he went to the Prophet. Before he got to the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him what? Text message. That's the fastest communication today, right? Text message. What was the text? إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمْ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ.
اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَىٰ مُحَمَّدٍ
وَآلِ مُحَمَّدٍ. Imam Ali, when he get out, the Prophet said, Ya Ali, come, what did he do? He said, Ya Rasulullah, what happened? He said, Al-An nazala alayya Jibra'il. Jibra'il just came down now and told me what you did. What did I do? Imam Ali asked the Prophet said, this is the ayah from Allah telling me that Allah is witness that you were given sadaqah when you were in the state of ruku'ah, which never happened to anybody throughout the history of mankind, except Imam Ali alayhi salam. That is one of the giving of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. Imam Ali with the giving, brothers and sisters, there are so many ayahs in the Quran about Imam Ali and giving, and Ahlul Bayt in general. One other ayah of Imam Ali given is Ayat al-Najwa. When the Muslims, they have a habit of going talking to the Prophet in private. The Prophet was not happy about it. But the Prophet with his akhlaq, he didn't want to stop them. And you know why the Prophet didn't want to talk to them in private as they used to? There are many reasons behind it, why the Prophet is not comfortable. But one of the main reasons, because some of them, when they come to talk to the Prophet in private, their mouth doesn't blow a good smell. Because most of them didn't use to brush their teeth. So when they come to talk to the Prophet, when they open their mouth, Allahu Akbar, a bad breath is everywhere, and the Prophet with his kindness, he takes it anyway. He can't say that, he can't be mean or say something that will hurt somebody's feelings. But Allah saw that. Allah wanted to stop it. Allah said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, all of you those who believe, إِذَا نَاجَيْتُمَ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقًا. Allah is good way to stop certain things. If you want to stop something, you put a price on it. And this is for all of us. You come to the masjid to pray, you put a price and say, anybody who wants to do Salat al-Dhuhr, he has to pay $10. See how many people are going to show up? Nobody's going to show up because money is involved. Right? That's human beings' nature. They don't want to spend money when it's not necessary. They want to save money as much as they can. Now those people, even though they love to talk to the Prophet in private, but as soon as the money came in, they say, we withdraw, we quit. But guess what? Imam Ali alayhi salam say, Ya Rasulallah, I am in. They quit, I'm in. What is it? The first day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting, the companions were around. The Prophet said, Ya Rasulallah, this is my sadaqah. He put the sadaqah in the box. He talked to the Prophet. The first day, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, 10 days, nobody among the companions spoke to the Prophet in private. After 10 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَأَشْفَقْتُمْ أَن تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقًا. In other words, shame on all of you. You fail to give sadaqah for you to talk to the Prophet? Is that too hard for you? فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَتَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allah says, if you fail to do it, I forgive you anyway. But the first person to come and act according to the ayah was only Imam Ali alayhi salam. Even the Imam Ali was not rich. And we're speaking about people who were rich among the Prophet's companions. Wealthy people, they were sitting there. Nobody was willing to give anything except Imam Ali alayhi salam. For 10 days. And it's amazing. Why 10 days? Why not 1 day, 2 days? There is a wisdom behind it. You know why? The wisdom is that Allah doesn't want to do it 1 or 2 days. Because then the munafiqun, they said, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was rushing. If Allah is to give it 2-3 days, we would have given it 2. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that. Allah opened the door for 10 days. Okay, you can tell I didn't have the first day, I didn't have a chance. The second day, you didn't have a chance. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, there is no excuse after that. And some of them, they said, we envy Ali for many things. One of them is Ayat al-Najwa. That the ayah was revealed and nobody acted upon it other than Ali alayhi salam. That is That is one of the importance of giving in Islam. There are so many ayahs in the Quran about giving from Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. So the first lesson from this hadith, from this ayah, from the story we just mentioned in Surah Al-Kalam, is Allah want to teach all of us the importance of giving like the old man used to give. That is number one. Lesson number two. Brothers and sisters, there is a link, connection between a sin and the cutting your risk from Allah. Meaning, if Allah is blessing you with something, ni'mah, risk is coming down, everything is fine for you, be extra careful to respond to Allah by committing sin. When Allah is giving you His blessings, don't let your response to Allah be sin instead. No. What should you do when Allah is blessing you? Instead, what you should do is what? You should also be a grateful servant. La in shakartum la azidanna. But if Allah is blessing with something, and then instead, I started to sin, disobey Allah, you know what Allah does in return? Allah takes that ni'mah from you. And that is what you see in dua command. Imam Ali alayhi salam, one of the dua he asked Allah, Allahumma ghafir li al-dhunub allati tughayyiru ni'am. Tughayyiru ni'am? Blessings. See, sometimes a person, a family, everything is going smooth. The family, everybody's healthy. Risk is coming. Everything is normal. When the family responded with the sin, the first thing Allah does is to take that ni'mah from them. Number two is to test them with different trials and troubles and problems. Why? Because they fail to respond to Allah by being grateful to Allah's servant. That is what we saw in this ayah. Look. The father, when he was alive and he was obeying Allah by giving, what happened? The ni'mah of Allah continuously coming. The farm continues to give the product. The benefit of the farm continue to come to the father and the family. But the night the children made the decision to prevent the poor people, Allah took that blessing from them. That's it. You know why? Because every ni'mah Allah gives you, Allah said, I put the share of a needy person on that ni'mah. Every blessing Allah gives you, Allah says, it's not just for you. There is other poor people also, they have share in it. You have to share with them. If you fail to do that, then Allah takes the ni'mah from you and he gives it to somebody else. Because you don't deserve that blessing. The same thing to this young man. Allah gave their father this farm. The farm was booming, was blessing for all of the family. And the father realized that. And he was giving to the poor people as the blessing continues to come. What they decided to prevent from these people, Allah said, you don't deserve it anymore. Allah took it and gave it to somebody else. That is one of the lessons, brothers and sisters. We have to be careful. Don't let your response to Allah's blessing to be you to sin and disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is number two. Lesson number three, which I think is the most important than the rest of the previous two. The most important thing, brothers and sisters, is the niyyah and the intention. The intention is the key for everything, brothers and sisters. In everything that we do, let your intention be pure and for the sake of Allah. If the intention is pure, then everything that you do will be blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read the ayah, brothers and sisters. When we mention the ayah, we mention that the young men, they had the need to prevent the poor people from the farm. But the question, did they do it? No, they did not. Just the niyyah. They have the intention. Tomorrow we're going to the farm. We will block all the entrances. We will not let the poor people come in. That is the intention. Did they practice it? No. But just that intention itself, Allah punished them for the bad intention. That is why we have to learn that the intention is very important. Niyyatul mar'i khayrun min amali. If the intention is pure, sometimes it's better than the action itself. A person, in fact, if a person have intention that I want to do something, just intention, I have intention to build a masjid. Did you build a masjid? No. But if the intention is pure, Allah tells the angel, Raqib, write in his hasanat as he has built the masjid. Ya Rabbi, he didn't build the masjid. Allah said, yes, I know. But because the intention is pure, Allah said to me, it's like he did it. A person, the intention is not good. He did the action. The action is there, it's dead. Allah said, don't write anything. Ya Allah, he did the action, it's there. Allah said, I don't want it. Why? Because the intention is not pure. Look at the riya. Al-mura'i, a person who does action for the sake of show off. The action is done. Two people, they did pray. The prayer is done. Ruku and sujood, recitation, everything is done. The one who prayed for the sake of Allah, the intention is pure, Allah said, write him hasanat. The other person, who the intention is not for the sake of Allah, Allah said, yes, he did the ruku, he did the sujood, but Allah said, don't write anything. Allahu Akbar. Example in the Quran, the children of Adam, alayhi salam, Habil and Kabil, listen to the Quran. Allah said, إِذَا قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا. They both sacrificed. Habil, he sacrificed. Kabil, sacrificed. But what did Allah say? فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنْ الْآخَرِ. Allah said, I accepted from one and not the other. Ya Rabbi, why? They both sacrificed. You said it. Karaba. They both sacrificed. They both gave for Allah. But Allah said, I took one, but I didn't take the other one. Why? Because Habil, his intention was pure. Qabil, the intention was not pure. Allah said, I don't like things that are impure. I like the ones who are pure. The same thing in every action, brothers and sisters. Hajj, you go to Hajj. Allah doesn't care about your tawaf, your sa'i, your safa and marwa, your sacrifice. No. Allah said, I don't care about that. Yes, you did it. That's fine. But what is care? What I care for is your inniya. Inna Allah la yanzur ila suwarikum. Walakin yanzur ila kulubikum. It doesn't matter what you do. Now you want to go up and down. Say, I built the masjid, I want ziyarah, I want hajj, I did umrah, I did. That's good. But the intention, is it clean or not? إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Every action is governed and led by the niyyah. If the niyyah is pure, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept anything. If the niyyah is not pure, Allah will not have nothing to do with that. That is why even the Prophet in one of the hadith, he said, يُحْشَرُ النَّاسُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَى نِيَّاتِهِمْ. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, when we get raised, we will be raised based on our intention. If the intention of person is pure and clean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him in the nice looking form. Some of us, will be raised in the form of human being. Some of us, if the niyyah is not good, will be raised in different form, different shapes. Some people, you know in the Quran, if the intention is not clean and pure, they will be raised in the form of animals. Depending on how the intention is. Some people, they will be raised in the form of pigs. Some people will be raised in the form of animal, chicken, cows, any animals you can think of. And listen to the Quran. One ayah expressed this point where Allah said, يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, when people of hellfire are in the fire, they were talking to the angel. Ya Allah, we want your forgiveness. Then the response comes from the angel of the angel of the hellfire. قال اخسأوا فيها ولا تكلمون. Look in Arabic, brother, prep carefully. The word اخسأ is used for animals, not human beings. The ayah when Allah SWT talks, the angel of the hellfire, when he responds to them, the people of hellfire, he doesn't say that, no, be quiet. No, he said اخسأ means is used for animal when the animal is making noise. That is where the word they're using there. But Yawm al-Qiyamah, we're talking about a human being. Because the niyyah is not pure. Brothers, everything we want to do, from tonight, I want us to pure our niyyah. Everything that you want to do. Salat you want to perform? Allah, first stop and purify that niyyah. Between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before you say, Allahu Akbar for salat, make sure that that niyyah is not for anybody, not for self, not for others or show up. It's just for his pleasure. Masjid you want to go. A work you want to go. Any action you want to do, let the intention be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if the niyyah is for Allah, it grows. Everything that you do, if the intention is for Allah, like Imam Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salam. He said in one of the hadith, he said, ما كان لله ينمو. Anything, if the intention is meant for Allah, he said, I guarantee you it will grow. It will prosper. وَمَا كَانَ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ. If something, it was meant for, not for Allah. What happened? وَمَا كَانَ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ يَكْبُ. الْكَبْ is going to turn upside down. Meaning, it's not going to grow. The intention is very important, brothers and sisters. Everything that we do, if you want to earn the pleasure of Allah, Allah said, I want you to purify that heart. Let the heart be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The young man and the ayah that we just mentioned, the problem is the intention they had is to prevent the poor people from the farm. And just that intention affected the farm of their farm. If we can always keep clean our heart for the sake of Allah, we have achieved a lot in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin, to purify our intentions, Ya Allah. Anything that we do, Ya Allah, let it be just for your pleasure, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you every single day, help us to come closer and closer to you, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, we ask you, show us the right path and help us to see the light, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, show us the wrong path and help us to stay away from it, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, we ask you, we have brothers and sisters who are sick and they need your treatment, your cureness, Ya Allah. Treat them and cure them as soon as possible, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. We have our brothers and sisters who are going through a very hard time, Ya Allah. Make it easier for all of them, Ya Allah. We have marhumin, brothers and sisters who pass away, Ya Allah. Be pleased with all of them, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, we ask you. We all have problems. Ya Allah, we ask you. Serve all mu'mineen and mu'minat. Their personal problem, their individual problem. Ya Allah, serve it for all mu'mineen and mu'minat, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you. Don't end our life unless we are true servant of yours, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. إلى أمواتكم وأموات المؤمنين والمؤمنات رحم الله من قرأ الفاتحة مع الصلوات
اللهم صل على محمد